If you want to create amazing mockups for Facebook ads or for promoting your digital product, I'm going to show you how to do it on Canva from scratch, but I'm also going to give you three different places where you can buy pre-made mockups where all you got to do is drag and drop your images into them. So here we go. Of course, the first thing you're going to want to do is head over to Canva. If you do not have Canva yet, get that free account. You can use one of my links in the description of this video. We're going to go over here to Canva, and I'm going to pretend that your digital product is already made. So we're going to pretend that this is like your ebook that you're wanting to create a mockup for. So this could be your ebook, okay? You made this, it's beautiful. You're going to actually either screenshot this or download it. You're going to save it to your desktop. Now, all you have to do is save the first page so that we have that image right there because it's beautiful, right? Whatever your cover image for, let's say, your ebook that you're wanting to sell, that is what you're going to download. Now, one thing that you can do when you do have that free Canva account is you can actually go over here to Canva and type in mockup, and you can see the different pre-made mockups ready for you to use. So you can actually get in here and you can drag and drop your images right in here, or you can create it completely from scratch, which I'm going to show you how to do in just a minute. So let's say you're going through here, you don't see any that kind of stick out to you, you want to create yours from scratch, like something like this. I'm going to show you how to do it. So what I like to do when I'm creating mockups is you have to think, okay, how am I going to sell these? Am I going to sell them on Instagram, Facebook, Pinterest, you know, whatever? That's going to determine the size of your starting document. So I'm just going to start out with Instagram, and I'm just going to type in Instagram, and we're going to go right here to a square post. This is going to give me my working document right here, and now I get to play. And so I get to come over here to where it says elements. I'm going to click on elements, and I can come in here and I'm going to type in computer. When I type in computer, you're going to go right over here. You can go into photos, or you can go down here to frames. You're going to say see all. You're going to be able to see all the different frames, that's what they call these, where you can drag and drop images into here. So as you can see, they have dragged and dropped images into here. Like, probably right here is an image of their homepage. This is your new website. So here's a screenshot that they took of their homepage, and they drag and drop that image right in there. So that's where you're going to find all of these. So we can start playing with how we want our mockup to look. So we're going to click and add. And then maybe we add a little laptop. Drag it down, and let's see, they even have phones, so you can say phone, and you can get an image of a phone here as well, and then they also have a tablet. So this is how you start creating your own mockup from scratch. So we'll go in here and say tablet. You can pick whichever one you want, and this is going to give us kind of a starting document for how we want our mockup to look. Now what we can do is, I just selected all of this, I'm going to move it to the middle. I really like these little snap lines that show me where the middle is. You might be saying now, that image that we downloaded over here, what are we going to do with that? Well, we're going to go back over here and we're going to drag and drop that image into, or we're going to upload, drag and drop or upload. Then we can drag that wherever we want. So let's say we drag this right over here, and maybe that's the cover for our ebook, and it's gonna be so beautiful and people are gonna be so excited for our ebook. Now, we can put whatever images we want into these three, or you may want to leave them plain and add text. So if you wanna leave them plain and add text, I'll show you what you can do. You'll go right back over here to elements. And what I like to do is I'll just type in color, and we'll go back over here to all. I type in color, and then you can pick one that matches your brand. So I like to go down here to photos, and then here's all the different colors that we can then drag and drop. So this one kind of goes with the vibe of that. We can play and see which one. We can even say, let's see, teal. Ooh, I like that. So I'm just dragging and dropping. I click, drag and drop, click, drag and drop, which this one I might even make that cover as well. We could do something like that. And then for here, we can put text over there if we want to, or if you want to add any additional images, like let's say, ooh, I like this one too. Okay, hold on. There we go. I like that. Get me out of here. I'm out of control. So I really like how this is looking, and now I can go back in and play with my text as well. So if you're new to Canva, you can scroll down here and see text that's already kind of customized as far as like the look and the feel and the fonts that they've kind of moved together. Or you can come up here and you can pick ones and customize it yourself. So I'm going to click right here, say add heading, and then whatever. Awesome. Ebook. Woo. We'll just say awesome ebook. I'm going to change the color right here where it says color. Change it to maybe a gold. Nope, that's hard to see. Just change it to white for now. You can, again, customize this however you want if you want it a different color. But we're just going to say something like that. I'm going to add a little subheading here. We can type in whatever. Then I'm going to copy and paste this and just move that right down over here to our other little laptop. And as you can see, this is starting to come together, right? Yay! It's magical. Magical. So cool. Now, what we want to do is make the background look good, right? We can't just have our cool mock-up here. We got to do something in the background if we're wanting to put this image around on social. Actually, what we'd probably do is customize it to where it matches the text of our, or the font of our ebook. But anyways, you get the point. So I'm going to go back here and I'm going to go here and pick different colors that I want for the background. So if this is teal, maybe I would look at, you know, just going off of these colors here, maybe I would look at like a light pink. Let's see what that looks like in the background. We can do something very light. We can come back to elements and add a border. If I know how to spell border. We can add something like this and start making it look pretty sweet. Now, what you can do is, of course, start customizing this however you want. And once you have this the way that you want it, you have your background, maybe you add in a ribbon down here that's like on sale now or save 50 bucks or, you know, whatever down here, then you're just going to download this image and you are good to go. So now you can see the background. I just added an image back there. I sent it to the back. I'm going to go ahead and add a banner down here. You can add whatever you want to start making this come together. So now you can start getting the idea of how you would build out your own mockup like this. Now, if you want the other places of how you can get mockups that are already pre-made, I'm gonna show you. You can actually head over to Etsy and you can type in mockups and you'll see tons of different mockups that you can use that are already pre-made. So let's check it out. So you'll see if you just type in mockups, you'll see a bunch of mockups for t-shirts and, you know, physical products. So maybe you want to customize your search and say digital product mockup. Here we go. So we have options here, 10 bucks for a ton of digital products. That's awesome. Digital product mockups. You can go and start scrolling through here. My philosophy is work smarter, not harder. If you can get ones that are already customized and reduce the time for you, do it. Right? So the only thing you want to watch with these, you want to make sure that you can use them for commercial use, which obviously a lot of these mockups, of course you can do that. But just, it's good to double check that you get the rights to use these and promote however you want. But here are all of the digital product mockups that are already ready for you to rock and roll and use. So that's one place. The next one is Creative Fabrica. Creative Fabrica has memberships. So kind of like Canva has a monthly payment. If you want to, they have the free version, then you have the premium version. This one does as well. You can get my link in the description. It starts at $4.99 and it allows you to use a ton of different ready-made digital products, designs, mockups, all sorts of things. You can actually, it's a marketplace as well, so you can sell on here as well if you want to. So we're going to go on here and say digital product mockup. Now, if you don't want to do the monthly, you do not have to. You can come in here and you can just pay per bundle. But a lot of these you can get super cheap. They're like a dollar, $11. And then with the $4.99, like the monthly subscription, you get access to all of these. You can download as much as you want, do whatever you want. And you also have tons of options as well. So those of you out there who are thinking of doing like print on demand, there are ready-made products over here where you can actually download designs that you can put on your print on demand products. You can download KDP interiors and exteriors. It's a really cool website. So check that out. The last one I'm going to show you is called Placeit. All of these are very similar. Some, they obviously have different designs, so you can just kind of ping pong back and forth between these and see if you can get exactly what you want. And if you can't, then you make your own, right? So you can come in here and say, design, whoops, boop. There it is, digital product mockup. So this is Placeit. And there are free options as well on here. And then, of course, they also have the subscription offer. There are free digital product mockup downloads that you can use on here. And they also have paid ones that you can do, or you can do the subscription. Totally up to you. But this should give you a good place to start as far as creating mockups for your own digital product. If you have any questions, let me know. And be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.